हेलो।
हेलो।
हेलो
हाँ, गुड मॉर्निंग।
हेलो हेलो,
हेलो,
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैडम।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग।
आप सर बोल रहे हैं, आप आगे करो। हेलो,
हेलो, गुड
हेलो,
मॉर्निंग सर। गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड
गुड
मॉर्निंग
मॉर्निंग सर।
मैडम,
क्लियर
वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग।
आ रही है सर? अ
आपकी आवाज नहीं आ रही है, बीच बीच में
वेरी
मिस
वार्म
हो
गुड
रही है।
मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल टुडे इन द गेस्ट।
वो तो कह रही है, लेकिन
ठीक सर, सर सर आप कंटिन्यू कर दीजिए।
हेलो। लो देखो
जी
मेरी।
सर।
हेलो। हाँ, मैं स्टार्ट कर देता हूँ। ठीक है, ठीक है, ओके। जो भी है, अब जैसा भी है, क्या कर सकते हैं। ठीक है। हेलो हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी, एंड थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर ऑल दी ऑर्गेनाइजिंग मेंबर्स ऑफ दिस प्रोग्राम, एंड पर्टिकुलरली द पैटर्न एंड चीफ पैटर्न एंड ऑल दी ऑर्गेनाइजिंग मेंबर्स एंड मोर ध्वज, एंड वेलकम ऑल दी स्टूडेंट्स। सो द टॉपिक गिवन मी for this deliberation or for this delivery, these nematodes, the hidden enemies of plants. So dear students, I think this may be a very new topic for you. I don't know whether you have heard the name of the nematodes or not, but these nematodes are very important, and still it is a untouched area, not very much touched one. So we'll discuss about this nematode today in this delivery. So what is the nematodes? Actually, everyone may be aware with the nematodes. The nematodes, the name nematodes came from this Greek word, nema. The Greek word is nema. Nema means thread. Thread means dhaga. Everybody may be aware with the thread. And everybody is knowing that oids means like. The form which is similar to the thread is known as nematode. So the nematode, the organelles are similar to the thread. So you may be seeing this structure. This is the nematode moving. So the nematodes are near about 30,000 species are known till now date, and out of these 30,000, only 10% nematodes, this is 3,000, they are harmful to the plants. They may attack on plants and they may cause different kind of damage to the plants. So in fact, on the basis of numbers, they are the most abundant among all the metazoans, and they rank at the second after insect. Means insect are the most more in number, but at second place nematodes are. So out of these 30,000, only 3,000 are plant parasitic nematodes. So today we'll discuss about plant parasitic nematodes. So in fact, nematodes, if we will discuss about the distribution or presence of the nematode, where the nematodes are present. So nematode may be present everywhere. You can see here in this slide, that they are present in the ocean, they are present in the hot water spring, and they may be present in the ice area, ice Arctic or Antarctic area, and they may be present in the barren land as well as they may be present in the cultivated land, and they may be present in the meadowland also. So it means they are present everywhere. They are present in cultivable land, they are present in the desert land, they are present in the fresh water, they are present in the ocean water. So everywhere, in rivers, everywhere the nematodes are present. So you can say that in fact they are omnipresent. And if we will talk about the this percentage, that in what percent where the nematodes are and in what percent they are harmful to the plant or animal. So near about 25% nematodes are in freshwater nematode, and are of total population 50% are marine nematode, and out of this 100%, 15% are animal parasitic nematodes, and 10% are plant parasitic nematode. Particularly we are concerned with these plant parasitic nematodes. So out of this 10%, 7% are completely parasitic, and 3% are beneficial also. So this is the total distribution of the nematode. And if we will classify on the basis of feeding habit, how they get their nutrition, so the nematode may be classified in these different category. As we discussed earlier, that 15% are animal parasitic. So they may be parasitic on animals. They means they may be parasite on a human being. They may be parasite on birds. They may be parasite this cow, buffalo, etc. So they are parasitic on animals. They may be parasitic on plants, or means near about 10% population is parasite on plant, and they may be parasitic on insects. And some of the nematodes are known as microbivorous, means they feeds upon microbes which are present. These microbes may be fungi, bacteria, so they may feeds on bacteria. And some are the predatory, they get nutrition on another way. And some are saprophytes, means they derive their nutrients, or they depend on for their nutrients on the dead and decaying material. So they play a very important role in So these saprophytes are very important in decomposition of material or recycling of nutrients. They play a very important role for decomposition of this dead and decaying material, and convert this dead and decaying material in the nutrition. As I discussed about this animal parasite, so all may be aware with this animal parasitic nematode. One very important nematode is Ascaris. So this is the figure of Ascaris. This slide is showing the different stages of Ascaris, and the overall population of the world is near about 25% population is infested with these worms, this Ascaris. So this Ascaris is very important nematodes. So means nematodes may be parasitic on human being, they may be parasitic on plants. So among nematodes, these they may parasitize on human being. So this among human being, this Ascaris lambricoides is very important, and these are the different stage. This is adult one, and this is larvae, and these are the eggs. This is the eggs also of this human parasitic nematodes. Then there is one nematode that is responsible for causing this disease. This is known as elephantiasis or filariasis. So everybody may be aware. And this is the photo showing the nematode infecting on this pupal stage of insects. So these are the nematodes. So these are the animal, insect parasitic nematode. And then, in fact, these among nematode, plant parasitic nematode are not harmful to the human beings. Okay.
पेस्टिस लाइट भी शो कर रहा है
उसको पूछो जरा पूछो हेलो पूछो थोड़ा दोस्त से
हेलो सर इधर तो नेक्स्ट क्लास चल रही है आराम से
हेलो मोहरत ध्वज आवाज आ रही है नहीं अभी स्लाइड जो मैंने शो की वो आ रही थी नहीं अभी आई पहले नहीं आई अच्छा इसका मतलब ये उसमें उस सिस्टम में नहीं जा रही है ये अगर प्रेजेंटेशन वाले मोड में डाल रहे हैं तो इसको मैं बैक करके स्लाइड दिखा दूं फिर दोबारा से आवाज गई होगी नहीं नहीं ठीक है ये पहली वाली स्लाइड पहुंची अब ठीक है नेक्स्ट अब सेकंड स्लाइड आई क्या क्या दिख रहा है इसमें ये दिख रहा है ये कल्सर दिख रहा है अच्छा अभी नेक्स्ट अच्छा ठीक है ओके सो सॉरी स्टूडेंट आई थिंक इन प्रीवियस मोड वी कैन नॉट शो द स्लाइड सो दीज आर द डिफरेंट फिगर्स ऑफ द नेमेटोड इन फैक्ट नेमेटोड मे बी ह्यूमन पैरासिटिक और एनिमल पैरासिटिक और फ्री लिविंग नेमेटोड्स और द शेप ऑफ द नेमेटोड इज जस्ट लाइक this photo so this is the ideal or photo of this nematode so there are three stages of nematode where they are adult then the adult lay the eggs and from eggs there is a vermiform larval stage so I already discussed about the population of the nematode. Only 30,000 species, only 3,000 species are plant parasitic. And this is about the distribution of the nematode. Nematode are present everywhere. And this is the overall percentage of the nematode. It means 10% nematode are plant parasitic and 15% are human parasitic. And human parasitic nematode are not harmful to the plant and plant parasitic nematode are not harmful to the human being. So these nematodes are parasitic as well as this, the microbivorous nematode are beneficial for the human being as a biocontrol agent as well as these septic nematode are beneficial for nutrient recycling. कैसे रुकिए आगे बढ़ा तो दिस स्लाइड इज शोइंग अबाउट दिस उसको उससे नहीं शो होती फिर दिस स्लाइड इज शोइंग द लाइफ साइकिल ऑफ दिस एस्केरिस आई थिंक एवरीबॉडी मे बी अवेयर विद दिस एस्केरिस नेम दिस इज वेरी सीवियर और हार्मफुल ह्यूमन पैरासाइट जस्ट फॉर गिविंग द आइडिया ऑफ प्लांट पैरासाइट नेमेटोड आई एम शोइंग दिस स्लाइड फॉर यू एंड देन दिस ह्यूमन पैरासाइटिक नेमेटोड देयर इज वन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट नेमेटोड कॉजिंग दिस एलिफेंटियासिस और फाइलेरियासिस डिजीज दिस डिजीज ट्रांसमिट थ्रू द दिस मॉस्किटो And this slide is showing that they may parasitize on different stage of insects. So these nematodes are parasitizing on this a pupal stage of insects. So they may be useful for management of the insect also. So if we will talk, because we are concerned about plant parasitic nematode, we are not concerned about the human parasitic nematode in this talk. So if we will discuss about the size of the nematode, the size may vary of the nematode, the human parasitic nematode or animal parasitic nematode may, this human parasitic nematode Ascaris size may be near about 1 foot. And in case of animal parasitic nematode, one nematode is this Placentinema. This is infecting blue whale, and the size of the blue whale nematode may be near about 26 feet. But the plant parasitic nematode are very, very, very small in size. They are not seen by naked eyes. That's why we call them hidden enemy of plants. And the farmer or even anybody cannot see these nematode by naked eyes. The size of nematode, plant parasitic nematode, is near about 250 to 3000 micron. This may be 250 to 3000 mean maximum size of plant parasitic nematode may be about 3 mm. So these nematode cannot be seen by naked eye. This is the photograph showing the endoparasitic nematode inside the root system. All these are the root system. In the root system, these are the nematodes. And if we will calculate or see the population of the nematode, this slide is showing the population of the different macro and micro organism in the soil. That in 1 meter, 1 square meter, if you will calculate the population of these organisms, so in 1 square meter, there may be 2000 earthworm, 2000 the calyptran, etc., 20,000 enchytrates, 40,000 springtails, and 120,000 mites maybe. But in 1 square meter soil, if you will extract the nematode, they may be parasitic, they may be free living, or they may be saprophytic. So near about 2 crore population of the nematodes may be in 1 square meter soil. So most of the in 2 crore population in 1 square meter soil, they most of the may be saprophytic or some microviviparous, and out of these some may be plant parasitic nematode. So you can imagine that what is the population of the nematode in the soil, or what may be the population of the nematode in the soil. So out of this population, there may be some nematode, maybe plant parasitic nematode. And or in the soil nematode, if we classify the soil nematode, these nematode may be classified in 2 category. There may be some beneficial nematode, and there may be harmful nematode. पूछो जरा ठीक से और वॉइस जा रही है पूछ रहे सो बेनिफिशियल नेमेटोड एंड हार्मफुल नेमेटोड मींस दैट 2 crore पॉपुलेशन इन 1 square meter दे मे बी कैटेगराइज इन 2 category बेनिफिशियल एंड हार्मफुल नेमेटोड एंड बेनिफिशियल नेमेटोड मींस द माइक्रोबियल फीडर्स सो दे आर रेस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर increasing the soil fertility, and there are some saprophytes, they are also responsible for increasing the fertility of the soil. And there may be some insect parasite, we call them EPN, insect parasitic nematode. So these insect parasitic nematode are responsible for management of the population of harmful insect in the soil. So that's why these nematode are beneficial nematode. What in this talk, we are concerned about the plant parasitic nematode. So near about 10% population may be PPN. We call them PPN, plant parasitic nematode. So we will discuss about the plant parasitic nematode. So shape may be similar in all the cases, in all the nematode. They may be this type of nematode. कर गया So this is ideal shape of a plant parasite in nematode. This is tail portion, this is mouth portion, and both the portion are tapered. And this nematode is similar to the thread-like. And this plant parasite nematode, I mean, in case of all the nematode, male and female are separate. Always this male is smaller than female. And the very specific character of plant parasite nematode is that these nematode are having a very specific structure. This is needle-like structure. This structure is known as stylet. And these plant parasite nematode use this stylet for getting the nutrition from the cell or getting the cell sap from the cell, as well as for putting this enzyme or digestive enzyme in the cell sap. So they use this stylet needle-like structure similar to the medical syringe, as doctor use the syringe for putting the medicine in the body, or they also use the syringe for getting the blood sample from the human body. So these two type of functions of this syringe in case of medical. Similarly, they use this stylet for this both function, for getting the nutrition from the cell sap, or sucking the cell sap, or for piercing or putting the enzymes or digestive enzyme in the cell sap for partially digesting the cell sap. So, and then these plant parasite nematode may have the near about all the function except this respiratory, the circulatory, and this system is not well developed. Otherwise, this reproductive system and sensory system, digestive system, all the systems are well developed in the nematode. And then so these are the near about 10 species, or you can say the 10 nematodes are very important from agriculture point of view. These nematodes are causing different diseases in the plants. So out of these 10 nematodes, I'm showing here only the name of the 10 nematodes. The root knot nematode is most important. In most of the plants, the root knot nematode causing damage in different way. And the genus of the root nematode is Miladogyne, and this is a very serious pest of the vegetable. That's why we also call this nematode vegetable nematode also. And then this root lesion nematode, cyst nematode, and this golden cyst nematode. This is the nematode of potato. This is also very serious pest of potato in some of the area. And then cistus nematode, dagger nematode, and this burrowing nematode is serious pest of banana and reniform nematode. So these are the different important species or genus of, sorry, important genus of the nematode, which are responsible for causing different kind of disease in the plant. And on the basis of this, there are two type of nematode. Yes. The nematode may be endoparasite, means they enter into the system of the plant and then they get their nutrition from the plant, or they may be ectoparasite, they remains outside the system and then feed upon the root. And there may be third category, partially they enter inside the system and partially they remains outside the system. So such type of nematodes are known as endoectoparasite. And there are two type of nematode. There are migratory nematode and another is sedentary nematode. Sedentary nematode, they remains stable at one place and continuously feeds upon the root system. And another migratory nematode, once they feed one place and then move to another place, so they are known as migratory nematode. So nematode may be migratory or sedentary, or they may be endoparasite, ectoparasite, and they may be into ectoparasite. So on the basis of feeding, they may be classified into categories, sedentary and migratory. And then again, these sedentary and migratory nematode may be classified into two categories, means endoparasite or ectoparasite. So Yes, this slide is showing the comparative size of the different pathogen of plant. So this is cell, okay, and you can see this is nematode, this larger size, and then second place this is fungi, and this bacteria, and then viroids, and then molecules. These are the virus particle. So it means this is a larger one pathogen of the plant. And then slide is showing about this endoecto and endoectoparasite. This is endoparasite. This slide is showing that these are the nematodes. They are the inside the system of the root. And this slide is showing ectoparasite. Outside the root system, there are several nematodes feeding upon the roots. And these are the nematodes. This is known as reniform nematode. This is endoectoparasite. Partially they are outside the system of the root, and partially they are inside the system of the root. So they are endoectoparasite. Okay. And then this is again, this slide is showing endoparasite and ectoparasite. These are the endoparasite. They are completely inside the system. This is endoparasite, this is endoparasite, and these are the ectoparasite. All these are ectoparasite feeding upon the roots. Cell, and these are the endoectoparasite. Partial body of the nematode is outside from the cell, and partial they are the inside the cell. So they are endoectoparasite nematode. And then what kind of damage is caused by the nematode? Nematode are responsible for causing different kind of damage to the plant. So there are two type of damage. Means direct, they may cause the harm to the plant, and they may be indirectly harmful to the plant. Means they are indirectly in maybe helpful for another pathogen, etc. So this is indirect damage. So direct damage, they feeds upon cell and they draw the nutrient and make this plant weaken, and they may cause some sort of root damage, and they may create some deformity and may choke the vascular system. And ultimately, the absorption of water and nutrient may be disturbed, and they may damage the growing tip of the root. So ultimately, they may disrupt the root system. So even they may cause some hormonal imbalance. In case of root knot nematode, there is an increase of IAA, and there is a formation of knot, and ultimately the whole root system may be disturbed or transformed. So these are the direct damage, and there are indirect damage. They may be responsible for causing different kind of wounds in the root system, and through these wounds may be helpful for the another pattern. For example, for the they may provide the entry points for the bacteria. They may provide entry point for some of the fungi. So they may cause some mechanical bolting, and then they may change the host. They may modify, they make some resistant variety may convert in the susceptible variety. So they may change the host. Even they may modify the rhizosphere. Rhizosphere is a area which is the area which is under the influence of root, or means which is under the influence of root accelerate. So generally in the rhizosphere area, the microbial population is too high. So these nematode may change this rhizosphere area also in some extent. And they are responsible for resistance breakers also. And this vector of pathogens, these nematode are very much important vector of some of the virus. Even not only virus, they are also responsible for transmitting the bacteria. For example, in case of Tundu disease, the coronibacteria is this nematode are helpful for this colony bacteria, and there are some virus. They are known as Nipu and Nitu virus. They can be transmitted only through nematodes only, plant parasitic nematode. So the nematode may play as role as a vector also, and the nematode may be may interfere in the nitrogen fixation also. So it means the nodule formation may be affected by plant parasitic nematodes. Now come on the symptoms. What kind of symptom produced by the plant due to the infestation of the nematode? There are so generally the due to nematode infestation, there are two kind of symptoms: above ground symptoms or below ground symptoms. So then most of the nematode feeds upon roots. So generally they may cause damage to the root system, and they may produce some of the symptoms in the root system. So the overall symptom may be classified into category above ground and below ground. So there are some photographs. So what are the above ground symptom? These are the different above ground symptom. One is premature wilting, means if there is a damage to the root system, so there ultimately in foliar portion you will see the wilting or dying of the plant. So wilting may be there. Then if there is a too much sharing of the nutrient by the nematodes, so there may be yellowing, chlorosis in the plant or leaf symptoms, and ultimately plant may become stunted, a dwarfing of the plant, and there may be some irregular symptom of the pattern. And then if there is damage to the root system, so naturally the if roots are shallow, so the plant may become susceptible to the drought conditions. So there may be unthrifty plants also. So these are the some symptoms which may see in the field if there is a damage due to nematodes. So these are the above ground symptom or foliar symptoms because of the nematode infestation. So these are the photograph. Now you can see this photograph. This is the area where plant are infested with the nematode. In case of nematode, generally the symptoms are not uniform. There these symptoms are in patches because the population of the nematode remains in patches, not in throughout the field. The population of the nematode is equal. This the nematode is very much unevenly distributed in remains in soil. And now this is the banana field. These are the banana plant infested with the this nematode, burrowing nematode. And now you see this cabbage plant. This plant is healthy and this is infected with the nematode. So this is instantic plant. And this this is a groundnut field. This plant are showing this yellowing. And this is sugarcane field. This line is, or these plant are free from nematode infestation, but these plant are infested with the nematode. They are small in size. They are showing the yellowing. So these are the different symptoms of the nematode. And this is the symptom of seed gall disease of wheat. This is a very important disease caused by nematode. First, this is the disease was first time reported in 1743 by Needham. This is the first disease caused by nematode, first time reported. So these are the due to nematode infestation. This plant, the grain convert in the black hard structure. These structures are known as cockle. And these are the healthy seed. So if there is an infestation of the nematode in the wheat crop, so all the grain converted in this form. In these cockles, the second stage larvae remains inside the system. So this is the healthy ear, and these are the infested ear with the nematode, and these are the cockles. They, in the form of these cockles, the nematode may survive more than 20 years. When these cockles will get the moisture, the second stage larvae comes out from the cockles, and the thousands of thousands, even in larks, one cockles may have the second stage larvae. So So these are the symptoms of the ear cocal disease of heat, very important disease. And then come on the below ground symptom. What are the symptoms? So these are the below ground system symptoms, very important. The roots are showing the symptoms of infestation of root node nematode. This nematode is known as miladobant, or we can call the disease vegetable nematode or vegetable root node nematode. So this is healthy root. You can see here all the roots are fibrous, very healthy. There is no any knot like structure, but in this case the all the roots converted in the knot like structure. So if there is a formation of knot, there is no proper absorption of water and nutrients, so ultimately the plant may become weakened and their plant may die or yield will affect. And this is the symptom, the root system of the rice. The rice plant, rice root system is showing. There are different gall. This is known as this caused by miladobant graminicola. So this is also this nematode is becoming very serious problem of the in rice field or for rice crop. And this is the photograph of potato infested with the miladobant nematode. And these are the carrot infested with the root node nematode. And this is healthy carrot. These are the infested carrot. So what will become the fate of these carrot? And who will buy in the market if your carrots is infested with this root node nematode? And these are the symptoms, means necrotic symptoms. Due to nematode infestation, there may be rotting in the root. And this symptom is known as lesion, or you can call them necrotic symptom, necrotic lesion on the root symptom. So if there is a such type of lesion, there may be infection or attack of the secondary saprophyte, and ultimately the root may become rotten. And this slide is showing the this is also very important nematode. This is known as cyst nematode. This cyst nematode may attack on pulse crop. This may attack on soybean. Even this may attack on a cereal crop also. So on the basis of the crop, we can call them cereal cyst nematode, pulse nematode, etc. So this you can see these are the cyst, and because of this cyst is hard structure, and in fact these are the female. They lay their eggs inside the body, and ultimately after at the maturity they become hard structures. So these hard structures are known as cyst. So at the time of maturity or of the crop, if you will dig out the root, then you can see these such type of structure, cyst like structure. So in this cyst form, the nematode may survive from one season to another season. So these are the symptoms of cyst nematode. And this slide is showing the loss caused by the nematode. This is very old data, 1999. And you can see here that vegetable are highly attacked by the nematode. So near about 12% nematode loss may be caused by this nematode only. Now come on the important part. So what are the different, so that was the brief about the nematode introduction. Now, in fact, we are studying all these pathogens only for one purpose, that is management of these pathogens. So what are the different strategy? What are the different methods for the management of the nematode? So as in case of other pathogens, in case of bacteria, fungi, similarly, same methods are being followed for the management of the nematode. So these are the different method, cultural method, physical method, biological, resistant and regulatory, and then ultimately chemical method. So these are the different method. By adopting this method, we can manage the nematode. So I think among these management methods, cultural method is more important, and even economical as well as environment friendly method. So through the cultural method, we can manage the different nematode. But for management of the nematode, I think biology or life cycle of nematode knowledge is very much important. If we are knowing the biology as well as life cycle of the nematode, then easily we can manage the nematode. We will be knowing the what are the strong point of this nematode and what are the weak point of nematode, or what are the stages on that stage we must attack. So through cultural practices, we can manage very easily the nematode. So the crop rotation is very important. Suppose your nematode is surviving only for 1 year in the soil, so then we can recommend the 2 years crop rotation. Means if there is no host crop available in the on the particular area, so if host is not available, then nematode cannot survive because of the small layer disease. This small layer fecal cyst nematode can survive in soil through the cyst, and then next year if main crop mean host crop, that host crop is cereal, this wheat and barley. If wheat and barley is there, then these second stage larvae will come out from the cyst. If then wheat and barley is not available, then this hatching will not be there. So if there is not available this host crop, so ultimately this population of the nematode will reduce in the soil. So through crop rotation we can manage the nematode. And then this fallowing, same principle apply in this case of fallowing. If there is barren land, land is free from any kind of crop, so if then any crop is not there, so on what these plant parasite nematode will feed? So if there is no proper nutrition for the nematode, so naturally ultimately the nematode population will reduce in this particular field. And then next method is flooding. If we are knowing that particular field is infested with the nematode, or nematode population is too high in that particular area, we can keep standing water for some time, for few days. If there is a standing water, so there is lack of oxygen in the soil, so because of lack of oxygen this nematode will die. So ultimately flooding is also important for reducing the population in that particular area. And then there are different crops. These crops are harmful to the nematode. These crops are two types. One is trap crop and another is antagonistic crop. Trap means waiting crop, means the nematode prefers these particular crop most. So there is one important crop, we call them Crotalaria juncea. So this Crotalaria is important trap crop. If your field is infested with the nematode, you sow this Crotalaria, all the root system of the Crotalaria will be infested by this nematode, means all the population will reach inside this nematode, this root system of this Crotalaria. And then before completing the life cycle, you dig out this Crotalaria and destroy it. So by this trap crop method, we can manage the reduce the population in this particular field. And then antagonistic crop, there are some of the crops that release chemical substance. These chemical substances are harmful to the nematode. They may reduce their hatching, they may kill the nematode population. So these chemicals released by these crops. So among these antagonistic crops, there are mustard, garlic, onion and marigold. So if your field is infested with this nematode, you can sow these crop for one season or 2 seasons, and with the help of these antagonistic crop, we can reduce the population of the nematode in that particular area. Then this organic manuring or amendment. So this organic manuring or amendment are also very important for reducing the population in particular area, for particular field. So in fact, what happens, this organic material is food for different microorganisms. means these microorganisms, they may be saprophyte, they draw their nutrient. So there are number of microorganisms remains in soil, they are beneficial directly or indirectly to the plant. So if we will add the organic material in the soil, there these bioagent population will increase in that particular soil. So these bioagent will be helpful for managing the population of these nematode, as well as when we are adding some organic matter in the soil, there is a decomposition, and due to decomposition there is a release of some organic these acids or toxic substances. So these toxic substances may be responsible for reducing the population of the nematode. So in different way, or this organic matter is very much helpful for reducing the nematode. So by adding the organic substances, for example, this neem cake is very effective for the management of nematode. So why, if the soil is infested with the nematode, we can add this neem cake also. And then healthy planting material, there are some resistant material we can use this healthy planting material. Nematode infestation is or dispersal of nematode is mostly by these nursery, particularly in fruit crop. The nursery is very important. Suppose your field is free from nematode, but if you are planting the crop with through nursery, if nursery is infested, then ultimately the nematode will reach in your area. So healthy planting material is most important. For example, you can take the example of rice. Suppose you are going to transplant the rice in your particular field. Your field may be free from nematode population, but the nursery grown in the area which is infested, so a whole nursery will become the infested and the nematode will reach in your uninfested field. So the planting material must be free from the nematode. So same case is in case of horticultural crop also. And removal and destruction of infested plant. Suppose your field, your crop is infested with the root of this nematode, and you are leaving this infested root in the soil, so naturally the population of the nematode will increase. So at the time of harvesting, you dig out the root and destroy the roots away from the field. So naturally you will reduce the population of the nematode in this particular field. So by this method, we can reduce the population and we can manage the nematode. And this summer plowing. Summer plowing is very effective. Previously, farmers, this summer plowing was very common activity adopted by the farmer, but nowadays the summer plowing is a gone case, I think. But summer plowing is very effective because due to summer plowing, this different stages of nematode exposed to the sunshine. So due to sunshine, this nematode structures may destroy it. So summer plowing may be very effective for the management of the nematode. And then next method is physical method. In physical method, the soil solarization is very much effective. You may be aware of this method of soil solarization. In case of soil solarization, we cover the soil with this polythene sheet. The soil should be moist and pulverized, and then cover this soil with the polythene sheet. In the this soil solarization technology may be applied in the month of May and June when there is a atmosphere temperature may be 40 to 45 degrees centigrade. So under this polythene cover, the temperature may reach 10 or 15 degrees centigrade more than atmospheric temperature. So suppose there is a temperature 40 degrees centigrade atmospheric temperature, and if you will cover the soil with this polythene sheet, so temperature may reach up to the 50 to 55 degrees centigrade temperature. So due to the increased temperature, the different stage of the nematode may be destroyed by this high habitat temperature. So this summer soil solarization is very effective, but this soil solarization very effective for the small area particle, for nursery crop also. And then this biological control method, the biological control method is also effective for management of, there are different bioagents available in the soil. The population of these bioagents may increase by different method. And if there is a sufficient population of bioagents, naturally these bioagents may manage the population of the nematodes. If there is not a sufficient bioagent, we can introduce the bioagent in the soils, and we can, and different kind of bioagents are available in the market. There is bacillomyces, there is some fungal bioagent, bacterial bioagents available in the market, and these bioagents may be utilized for the management of the nematode. And then these resistant varieties, in some of the crop, the resistant varieties are available, so we can use these resistant variety for the management of this nematode damage. And there are regulatory methods. I think you may be aware with the regulatory method. This is known as quarantine method. If they one area is infested with the nematode, so we must stop the movement of this infested material from one area to another area. So generally, this is the rule made by the government. This regulatory method may be, or this quarantine may be state level or international level. So different kind of quarantine method, we can manage the movement of the nematode, and we can manage the nematode population. Particularly in India, this golden nematode is under quarantine. That is, previously it was confined to this hilly area, Nilgiri hill area, but now it is spreading to other area. So, and then next, last one is chemical control method. Different in case of nematode, for nematode management, not too much chemicals are available, only few chemicals are available. Particularly this carbofuran, furadan, these are the insecticide. They are less recommended for management of insect, but we can use this chemical for the management of the nematode also. If your field is infested with the nematode, we can apply these carbofuran and furadan also. There are some other chemicals available. Newly registered chemicals are, one is Vellum Prime, is from Bayer company, and another is the Nimit by Adama, and these are specific nematicide, and they are latestly recommended nematicide, and we can use the nematicide also. And then last one is integrative management, means by timely application of the different methods of the management, we can manage the nematode. So I think this is all about the nematode. So thank you very much. Sorry, the system was not functioning very well, so this we can not perform the talk very effectively. Hello.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Sir has given a very detailed lecture on nematode. Sir has given a very detailed lecture note on this nematode, the soil nematodes and parasitic nematodes. Their structure and characteristics were also discussed in detail by Professor Kamal. The role of Ascaris has been beautifully described by comparing it with the medical line. The above ground and below ground symptoms were also discussed by Professor Kamal. The strategies for the management of nematodes in organic farming was also discussed, which is a very burning topic today. But although sir has given a very brief detailed lecture on this nematode management, how we can manage the nematodes, what is the role of nematodes, but we missed a major part for Professor Kamal. We have missed the introduction, so I would like to introduce sir among you all. Sir has completed his master's in mycology and plant pathology from BHU Varanasi with minor in entomology in the year 1989, and doctorate degree in plant pathology with minor in entomology from GBBUAT Pannagar in the year 1994. Professor Kamal Khilari has more than 25 years of experience of teaching, research and extension in the field of plant pathology. Sir has guided 18 MSc and 11 PhD students of agriculture discipline for their thesis work, and 40 MSc AG and 25 PhD students as the member of the advisory committee. Regarding the professional development of Professor Kamal Khilari, he has attended 12 training courses on various aspects of 5 to 21 duration. Dr. Kamal has 34 research papers, 38 popular articles, 3 book chapters and 18 leaflets to his credit. Professor Kamal has been the PI in 7 major projects and has also handled 4 projects as a co-PI in other projects. Sir has been awarded with the Fellow of Indian Phytopathological Society. Sir is also a life member of Indian Phytopathological Society and a member of Indian Science Congress. So this was a brief introduction of Professor Kamal Khilari. Thank you very much, sir, for sparing your valuable time. And we are also sorry for this technical issue. So that's why we can't introduce you in the before lecture. So thank you very much, sir. And I also thank the faculty members and dear students for attending this lecture, which was very beneficial for the students. I also thank our college technical team and his staff members for making this event successful. Thank you very much, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you for all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, well.